morning, students of class 10. In this period of mathematics, we are solving exercise 4C of ratio and proportion. Question number 16. The question is, if x plus y plus z is not equal to 0 and x plus y by ax plus by equal to y plus z by ay plus bz equal to z plus x by az plus bx, prove that each ratio is equal to 2 by a plus b. As per the statement, here each ratio is written, so we will apply the property of equivalent ratio. Since given information I have written here, x plus y by ax plus by equal to y plus z by ay plus bz equal to z plus x by az plus bx. So from equivalent ratio property, the sum of numerator, this equal to the sum of numerator by the sum of denominator. So for that I have added all these numerators. I got x plus y plus y plus z plus x, and denominators ax plus by plus ay plus bz plus az plus bx. Here 2x plus 2y plus 2z by a common, then x plus y plus z inside the bracket, next plus b common, then x plus y plus z inside the bracket. Now we are getting 2 common, x plus y plus z inside the bracket, and here a plus a, x plus y plus z common inside the bracket a plus b. So this x plus y plus z and x plus y plus z both are cancelled. That is equal to 2 by a plus b. Therefore, each ratio is equal to 2 by a plus b, proved. In question number 18, if x by b minus c equal to y by c minus a equal to z by a minus b, prove that, question number a, x plus y plus z equal to 0. Here I have written the given information. Since x by b minus c equal to y by c minus a equal to z by a minus b, so from equivalent ratio property, I have added the numerators and denominators. I got x plus y plus z by b minus c plus c minus a plus a minus b will also be equal to any ratio, either this or this or this. So I have taken this one, x by b minus c. So implies that, here should be the symbol of implies that, not equal to, implies that x plus y plus z by all this plus minus cancelled, 0, x plus y plus z by 0 equal to x by b minus c. Therefore x plus y plus z equal to, by cross multiplication, equal to 0, proved. In question number 19, if a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 0, and if x by b plus c equal to y by c plus a equal to z by a plus b, then prove that x into b square minus bc plus c square plus y into c square minus ac plus a square plus z into a square minus ab plus b square equal to 0. So for that, here I have written, I have taken the first this, x by b plus c, I multiplied numerator and denominator by b square minus bc plus c square. I got x into, so I got this much, and x into b square minus bc plus c square, this b plus c into b square minus bc plus c square equal to b cube minus c cube. This is the formula. Now second, similarly, y plus y by c plus a equal to y into numerator and denominator both are multiplied by c square minus ac plus a square. So I got y into c square minus ac plus a square by c cube minus a cube. Similarly, and z by a plus b equal to z into a square minus ab plus b square by a cube minus b cube. Here we are getting this much, multiplying both numerator and denominator by a square minus ab plus b square. Now I have used equivalent ratio property. I have added all the numerators and denominators. I got this much, that is equal to any ratio we can take. I have taken here x by b plus c. So what are we getting? X b square minus bc plus c square plus y c square minus ac plus a square plus z a square minus ab plus b square, all these are cancelled, 0 equal to x by b plus c. Therefore this numerator equal to, by cross multiplication, equal to 0. X into b square minus bc plus c square plus y into c square minus ac plus a square plus z into a square minus ab plus b square equal to 0, proved. In question number 21, if 8a minus 5b by 8c minus 5d equal to 8a plus 5b by 8c plus 5d, then prove that a by b equal to c by d. From equivalent ratio property, I have added the numerator and denominator. I got 8a minus 5b plus, here plus, 8a plus 5b by 8c minus 5d plus 8c plus 5d. So minus 5b plus 5b cancelled. Here minus 5d plus 5d cancelled. We are getting 16a by 16c. This 16, 16 cancelled. We have a by c. Secondly, I have subtracted numerator and numerator and denominator denominator. So I wrote here 8 minus 5b minus here minus minus 8a minus 5b. So in subtracts, after subtracting, we are getting 8a minus 5b minus, at this place minus will come minus 8a minus 5b. Similarly, 8c minus 5d minus 8c minus 5d. So plus 8a minus 8a plus 8c minus 8c cancelled. We have minus 10b by minus 10d. So minus 10 minus 10 cancelled, b by d. Now, in this way, this a by c equal to b by d, I wrote here. And then we can write this ratio in this way, that a by b equal to c by d, by cross multiplication or from the ratio, from the property of proportion, we can write a by b equal to c by d, proved. In question number 22, if x equal to cube root of m plus 1 plus cube root of m minus 1 by cube root of m plus 1 minus cube root of m minus 1, then prove that x square minus 3mx square plus 3x equal to m. Here given that x by 1 denominator is not given, so we consider there 1, there is 1, x by 1 equal to cube root of m plus 1 plus cube root of m minus 1 by cube root of m plus 1 minus cube root of m minus 1. By component 1 dividend 2, I have used this property here. So this denominator will be added once with the numerator x plus 1, and next time denominator will be subtracted from numerator, that is x minus 1, x plus 1 by x minus 1. Similarly, this denominator will be added to the numerator. I wrote here cube root plus cube root of m plus 1 plus cube root of m minus 1 plus cube root of m plus 1 minus cube root of m minus 1. This denominator is added with the numerator, I wrote here. And by now the denominator will be subtracted from the numerator. Cube root m plus 1 plus cube root m minus 1, this is numerator, minus this denominator will be subtracted. So this will be minus cube root of m plus 1 minus minus plus cube root of m minus 1. Now this plus this minus cancelled. Similarly, this plus this minus cancelled. We have 2 into cube root of m plus 1 by 2 into cube root of m minus 1. This 2 cancelled. We have cube root of m plus 1 by cube root of m minus 1. Now cubing both sides, cubing this side and cubing this side. So I wrote x plus 1 whole cube by x minus 1 whole cube. As you cube this, then it will be only m plus 1. As you do cubing of denominator, then you are getting m minus 1. So this is the formula: a plus b whole cube, a cube plus 3 a square b plus 3 ab square plus b cube. For that, x cube plus 3 a square b, b is 1, plus 3 a b square, a is x and b is 1, plus b cube means 1 cube is 1. Similarly, here also a minus b whole cube, a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube, a is x and b is 1. So x cube minus 3x square into 1 equal to 3x minus 3x square plus 3x into 3x 1 square. So 3, that is equal to plus 3x minus b cube means 1 cube, that will be 1. And here m plus 1 by m minus 1. Again, I have used component 2 and dividend 2. So this will be added to the numerator, and again this will be subtracted from the numerator. For that, this became the addition of numerator and denominator, and this became the subtraction of numerator and denominator. Here also this will be added to the numerator. So m plus 1 plus m minus 1 by this will be subtracted from numerator, m plus 1 minus m minus minus plus 1. Now in this, this plus minus cancelled. Here also plus minus cancelled. What is left? 2x cube plus 6x by 6x square plus 2 equal to 2m by 2. Here also minus minus plus cancelled, and here minus plus cancelled. We have got this much. So 2 common x cube plus 3x by here also 2 common 3x square plus 1. This side 2 cancelled equal to 1. By cross multiplication we are getting x cube plus 3x equal to 3mx square plus m. That is equal to x cube plus x cube minus 3m is x square. This came this side, so sign will change. plus 3x equal to m proved.